¿Qué tal, amigos? ¿Cómo están? Una nueva edición de Auto 060 aquí en Cristina Radio Network, canal 153 de Sirius XM Radio. Bueno, y después de hablar con Tom Peters, el diseñador en jefe del exterior del nuevo Corvette Stingray 2014, después de la prueba de manejo que hicimos por allá en California, decíamos, manejamos casi 200 millas y después una prueba de performance en la pista. Vamos a hablar ahora con Thach Juchter, que es el ingeniero en jefe que desarrolló lo que es la potencia y todo lo que tiene que ver con el desempeño del nuevo Corvette Stingray 2014.
Well, Thach, thank you very much for having us here on the first driving event for the new Corvette, 7th generation Corvette. And so for you guys, it's what, like four years in development and then like auto show showing and then all these things. And now finally here on driving it.
It's just awesome to be here. It's been 4 years of focused development, but it's really been 60 years in the making. We stand on the success of the previous cars and the people who worked on the previous cars. So, we're really happy to have it out here and be able to showcase it for everybody.
Yeah, big responsibility, because as you say, it's a car, it's an iconic car for not only for Chevrolet, but for like the whole United States, basically for the whole United States auto industry.
Yes, it's a lot of responsibility. We take it very seriously, and we've had excellent support from General Motors, Chevrolet, to try to put together a car that's really fantastic, spectacular in every way.
Yeah, a lot of technology and the engine, the suspension, and everything. Can you talk a little bit about that? When they presented first, they said 150 horsepower. Now I hear 460.
It's 460 horsepower. That's with the optional exhaust. Oh, okay. The standard car is 455 horsepower and a lot of low-end torque. And you mentioned technology. There's technology everywhere you look on the car. You can hardly pick up a part of the new Corvette and not have a technology story, whether it's the magnesium frame and the seats, whether it's all new aluminum structure, whether it's the first time use of carbon fiber on Class A panels on a standard Corvette, the infotainment, two high definition screens inside the car. Pretty much everywhere you look, the electronic limited slip differential, there's a story to be told, and it is all focused on improving the driving experience.
So the car, the new car is like 98%, I believe, like everything is new, but it's like for like a couple parts, maybe small parts?
There's only two parts that are carried over from the previous car.
Yeah, and besides all that and the new technology development, the price is still not that high for what you get in this car. I mean, you mentioned some other vehicles to compete with, but really, for the price and what you get, there's really hard to compare.
Well, thank you. We've held the price essentially carryover. If you look at the content, there's some standard content that was optional on the previous generation car. It's essentially a carryover price, so you get all that technology for free.
Yeah. And so this car, I mean, it's been, like as we said, an American icon, and but not very popular in other parts of the world. But with this one, that's more or less what the thinking behind that new design was, right?
Well, we think it's a more international design. We think making the car out of aluminum, which is perceived as a premium execution, having carbon fiber on the car. I think the combination of excellent fuel efficiency and excellent performance, I think we have a chance to sell far more cars overseas than we have previously. But the truth is, we'll wait and see. We're planning to distribute the Corvette globally, and if everybody wants it, we'll build them some.
Exactly. I mean, we're driving here in Monterey, in California, and the reaction is amazing. Everybody thumbs up to the car everywhere it goes. So I'm sure, have you had that kind of reaction when you're testing in Germany and all those places?
Yeah, it's really surprising, the reaction. We knew the car would be perceived as a different, obviously different car. We didn't realize the design, the power of the design, where the reaction to people would be so visceral, where they almost can't help themselves. They're drawn to the car. So we have people chasing us down, wanting to get their picture by it, or even chasing us to our homes, wanting to get more information about the car.
Well, that's a good sign, I guess, for what's coming up for
very good Eagle sign.
Yes. Thank you very much, and congratulations again for the fabulous car.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye.
Pues ese fue Thach Juchter, el ingeniero en jefe que estuvo trabajando durante 4 años en el desarrollo del nuevo Corvette Stingray 2014, el auto que ya muy pronto va a estar a la venta acá en Estados Unidos y empieza con un precio fabuloso que es de apenas $51,995 para el coupé y 56,995 para el convertible, pero para ser totalmente justos, el que estuvimos probando por allá en California tenía un precio de $64,000. Sin embargo, por ese precio, $64,000 con un motor V8 de 6.2 litros que da 460 caballos de fuerza y además una gran cantidad de tecnología en el motor, en la suspensión, un muy mejorado diseño interior, que era una de las grandes fallas que tenía el Corvette anterior, el C6, en comparación con sus competidores. Realmente por $64,000 todavía es un auto, es mucho auto por esa cantidad de dinero. Así que bueno, esa fue la presentación que tuvimos en California para el nuevo Corvette Stingray 2014. Y como les decía, en el último segmento de este show vamos a hablar con mi colega Laura Bernstein, que es con quien estuve manejando por allá por las calles, carreteras de California y después en una prueba de autocross ahí en el aeropuerto municipal de Monterrey. Y ella nos va a dar las impresiones. Vamos a compartir un poco lo que fueron nuestras impresiones de la primera prueba de manejo del Corvette Stingray 2014. Y no se vayan, que cuando regresemos aquí en Auto 060, todos los conceptos, los prototipos que vimos en el Pebble Beach Concours de Elegance. Esto es Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota.